Hi Goleta, my name is James Campero. I'm the Deputy Public Works Director for the City of Goleta, and I'm excited to discuss a very important project that Public Works is currently working on finalizing, the citywide LED street lighting conversion project. Here in the City of Goleta, there are approximately 1,600 street lights within the city right of way that help light up our roadways, our sidewalks, really our entire city. Majority of these street lights were actually installed back in the 1960s, way before a city was even incorporated. And the existing street lights we have older high-pressure sodium streetlight fixtures. These high-pressure sodium streetlight fixtures have been around for a long time. They're not energy efficient. They produce a low quality orange light. They have diminished light output over time. They have a shorter lifespan than the most current streetlight fixtures. They allow light trespass into yards and light escape upward into the sky. Because of this, high pressure sodium streetlights have been slowly phasing out. And recently there has been a drastic increase in the number of cities and municipalities converting their streetlights to newer, more energy efficient LED lights. In 2017, the city decided to take advantage of a program offered by Southern California Edison that essentially allowed cities to purchase and acquire most citywide streetlights that were owned by Edison, which is approximately 1,300 streetlights. The benefit of this is it would allow the city the opportunity to convert the streetlight fixtures from high-pressure sodium lights to newer energy-efficient LED lights. In general, the streetlight conversion will significantly reduce energy consumption, estimated at over 370,000 kilowatt hours per year, provide energy cost savings estimated to be over 100,000 per year, which is about a 50% reduction, help reduce greenhouse gas emissions, and the conversion would also provide significantly longer lifespan for our streetlights, improve lighting, enhance lighting control, and significantly lower maintenance costs. So overall, a great project for the city. And with the acquisition complete, the city was then able to move into the design and conversion phase of the project.
Our design team based our selection on several important design criteria. First up is the color of the light, known as the color temperature. This value, measured in Kelvin, essentially describes how white our LEDs are. This number can vary greatly, but for reference, the dull orange glows that you see with the current HPS lights is at about 2,200 Kelvin. When agencies first started implementing LED streetlights, the approach was typically brighter is better. Harsh white 5,000 Kelvin or more bulbs went up around the globe, and it wasn't too long before cities began adopting lower color temperatures to ease the strain on people's eyes, settling to around 3,000 Kelvin, like these fixtures you see in the background here. We received a lot of very useful feedback, which led us to the decision to take our design a step further. Our design team will be recommending Goleta LEDs to be 2,700 Kelvin across the board. These lights offer the best visibility while taking into account nighttime ambience and the quality of life. Another important factor in our design was the effect these lights will have on the night sky. Our team's goal was to make sure the lights that we selected were compliant with dark sky standards. This means the lights must not create any uplight. Current HPS fixtures do not meet this standard, hence that orange glow in the sky when you look at the city from a distance. On the other hand, LED lights benefit from improved light control and are able to focus output downward onto the street where it's useful. Because of this criteria, all of the lights we tested in our pilot study were dark sky compliant with zero uplight, as will be the fixtures our team will recommend moving forward. Our team's streetlight design will implement different fixture types with varying wattages depending on your neighborhood and road type. Higher traffic areas will be lit with higher wattage lights, and lower traffic areas will have low wattage lights. Once installation is complete, our team will still happily take in any requests for any lights that may need additional shielding to mediate any light trespass. We will also be glad to take any more input you may have for this project. For more information, please visit our webpage at cityofgoleta.org/LED streetlights. On that page, you will find more information about the location of pilot lights and an FAQ that may help answer your questions, which we will continue to update with new information.
The design maps for the LED street lighting project are available to view on the website.
Thank you for taking the time to watch this video, and as always, we welcome, encourage, and desire all public input and comments. please review our city streetlight website and contact me if you have any questions or comments.